Okay. So, I'm back with my telemedicine conference calls. So, let me open my patient's file. Her name is Savannah. I'm going to talk with her in a minute, but she did send more of a comprehensive file to me, so I'm going to go ahead and look at what she sent.
My name is Savannah Joseph. I'm 25 years old. So I was born with macrodactyly.
As a baby, my second toe was as big as an adult toe. And when I was 6 months old, I had the second toe completely removed. My big toe is the one that I really have a huge problem with.
And the bottom is very callousy. It's really uncomfortable and it makes me walk kind of sideways. My toe hurts when I'm wearing shoes. I wish I could wear sandals. I couldn't wear heels to prom, so I had to wear Converse. It's just something I've been self-conscious about for my entire life.
This video is giving me a good idea of what's going on. Savannah has macrodactyly. That's something that she was born with, where basically her toes are abnormally big. I did have a patient with macrodactyly. His name was Brian. Brian happened to have reactive arthritis in his foot, which unfortunately, I couldn't really save the toe. So in his situation, an amputation was the best form of treatment. Ah man, I'm gonna have to be really creative with Savannah. This is an incredibly painful condition. I cannot believe that she's been walking around on a foot like this for so long. Savannah has macrodactyly. That's something that she was born with, where basically her toes are abnormally big. I'll definitely have to address this in a very creative way. I'm excited to discuss this with Savannah to see what she thinks. So let's get Savannah on the phone and see what she has to say. Hi, Savannah. How are you?
Doing good, thank you.
That's awesome. I know that things have been crazy, so the world shut down, right?
Yeah.
Well, listen, thanks for sending over your pictures, but I do want you to just kind of summarize everything for me. Tell me about your previous surgeries and then how you are now.
I think I had 5 other surgeries just to debulk the toe, but it kept growing. It didn't help that at all. I haven't even shown my boyfriend my toe. We live together, and so at home, I'm sure he knows. But at home, I'll wear like slippers, I'll wear socks. I'm never walking around barefoot ever. The only people who know about my foot, who I've actually come out and have told, have been family members and people who I've grown up with who have obviously seen it.
I remember in high school when my friends and I would go to the hot tubs in the middle of winter, and I would sprint to the hot tub just so people around that were there wouldn't see my foot. And I was just super self-conscious about it, even when it was debulked and smaller.
I hear ya. You know, it's great that you're sharing your story because macrodactyly is not something that you could have helped at all. This is hopefully gonna, you know, normalize it and make sure people are more aware of it. So maybe hopefully you won't be as self-conscious. You live with your boyfriend who's never seen your foot.
I'm sure he has, but he hasn't said anything. And I haven't said anything because it just makes me very nervous.
I see. Does he know it causes you pain or?
Yeah. I'll get shooting pains in my toe. It feels like knives or like needles are being poked in there. So I got my last surgery done to debulk it. My toe just keeps growing.
I do want to get into seeing your actual foot. Just kind of like tilt the screen down and kind of put your foot up. So you're in, there we go. Okay. All right. Yeah, that like just like that. That's perfect. Okay. So your big toe is very bulky. I can actually see a little bulging on the top of the toe, on the foot too. Yeah, right there.
Yeah, you can really feel how much tissue's in there.
Yeah, it's like very like pliable, almost bouncy.
Yeah.
Kind of. Can you put the foot a little bit more close to the screen for that? Yeah, like that. Okay. Oh yeah, it is a little bit calloused underneath there.
Show both feet together.
So that is a big toe that you got. Can you move it around for me? Kind of like move it up and down. Okay. Does that hurt at all?
Nope.
What about the tip right there? Is that portion really hard?
That's, yeah, I can feel the bone in there. That's really hard. That really hurts.
Okay. I do want to go ahead and get a bit of a physical examination on you, though. So this is the part where we get a little creative. So if you could take your computer and set it on the floor.
All right.
All right. And can you simulate a lunge for me so I can see how it is when your toe goes up? How was the pain when you did that? Was it painful or were you okay?
The pain feels like it's right in here. That's another thing is I'll lose balance a lot, like while I'm trying to do a lunge or something on this foot.
Yeah. It's just a pretty unstable joint that's becoming a little bit arthritic. I think that's what's going on with you.
And there's a bone on the top right of my toe that sticks up, and that's a huge problem with shoes, so I want to take that bone away.
Okay, so you can go ahead and get settled back up on the chair where you were comfortable. Savannah, you have macrodactyly that is causing you to have already arthritis at this young age. That's why you're having pain with bending the toe when you're doing lunges and stuff. There are two joints in your toe, in your big toe. The one that you're flexing back and forth, there's that one. And then there's the distal tip one. So I did see your x-rays. What I will tell you is that the bones themselves are very enlarged. And right where you're saying you have that tip of the toe that's painful, that is a bone underneath there. Good news for you is that you do have like actual joint spaces that are not like a reactive arthritis type of situation. On your x-ray, it doesn't look bad, but it could get there. My preliminary plan is to consider fusing the bones in your foot. It's fused in a way that you can do your lunges, you can walk, you can hike, you can do all of your activities, but the bone, the joint won't move, okay? The other thing we need to consider is whether or not we amputate that distal tip of your toe, so that way all the rest of your toes can be even, okay? And then obviously I'm gonna debolt the rest of that soft tissue around it to make it look smaller. So that's the preliminary plan. So this is just the first step. The next step, I'm going to do my own physical exam on you to kind of figure out the best way to treat you and get onto the surgical planning.
All right. Awesome.
I'm going to do my best to help you with the pain in your foot. So the next time we see each other, hopefully we'll be in person once the world opens up again.
Awesome. Okay? Awesome. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome. I'll see you soon. Okay.
All right.
Okay. Bye.